In this video, we will be going through the ISL Light settings that are available to us before and during a remote desktop session. So the settings can be found by clicking on the menu on the top right corner of ISL Light. Let's go through some of these options and give them a closer look. The Overview tab is a dynamically generated list containing a gather of all the settings that were changed and that are now different from their default value. So for example, we previously set ISL Light to update every week instead of every day, and that can now be seen here. Each setting in the Overview tab has a reset option next to it. By clicking it, the value of the setting will be reverted to default, and the setting will be removed from the Overview tab. Now in general, we can adjust whether we would like ISL Light to download updates every day, week, month, or ever. ISL Light will automatically download the updates according to our selected setting, but we will still have a choice when we want to actually install them. In the dashboard settings, we can choose whether we would like to see the Computers tab or the Session tab when ISL Light opens. If the Show Session Invitation Window When a Session is Started option is ticked, ISL Light will prompt you to enter the email of the person you are connecting to as soon as you start a new session. This comes in handy if we only want to send session invitations using email. Here, we can set whether we would like the ISL Light toolbar to be on top, right, or left of the in-session window. If we would like to automatically end an inactive session, we can provide the desired amount of time of inactivity required in minutes before the session ends. So if we set this to 5 minutes, for example, ISL Light will monitor the activity of the operator. If the operator is inactive for more than 5 minutes, the session is automatically closed. This comes in handy when using an ISL Online's pay-per-use coupon, for example, where we need to take care of our minutes used. If there's a file being transferred, however, ISL Light will keep the session active. Here, we can set a specific time before a warning is displayed to the operator before a session is terminated due to inactivity, allowing the operator to resume the session. Now, during an ISL Light session, the options in the remote desktop area of the settings menu will be available to us. They are not shown if we are not already in a session. So let's start with desktop sharing, where we can set up our stream quality. We can choose between high speed or best quality. High speed will prioritize the quality of the connection, whereas best quality will prioritize the resolution. This is useful when dealing with varying internet speeds. Now, if your connection is lost for any reason, this option here will ensure that the remote machine locks upon disconnection. And here, we can choose whether or not we would like to enable or disable copy-pasting during a remote desktop session. Now, in the Files Transfer section, we can set a default destination folder for transferred files by clicking on Change, navigating to the desired folder, and clicking Select Folder. So let's just close this and locate the last option in the File Transfer, which is to choose whether or not you would like a dialog to appear after having transferred a file. Now, the Recording section allows us to change a few settings, such as the destination folder where the recorded files will be saved to. We can also choose to play the recording as soon as it's finished and choose whether or not we want ISL Light to start recording upon starting a new session from now on. Audio and video settings are available in the Talk section. These options will only be visible when a call has been started. When we are in a call with the remote side, we can select which audio capture device we would like to use and adjust the volume. We can turn on echo cancellation in case we're in a place with unideal acoustics. We can also set the audio playback device and test it. Similarly to the audio, we can adjust the settings for our camera in the video section by clicking on the device that is going to be used and setting the video quality. So that was our basic overview of the ISL Light settings. We welcome you to take a look at our guides, which explore every setting in detail. If you have any questions, join us on our live chat, and we will gladly assist you further. See you next time!